Hi, Professor Vishal Taylor. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video, I teach you hydraulic ram. That is a part of the hydraulic devices in a fluid mechanics and a fluid power engineering. In this video, I discuss you the four topics. First one is the functions of a hydraulic ram, why it is used. Second topic is construction of hydraulic ram, means which are the various components that are used in a hydraulic ram. Third one is the working, in which principle hydraulic ram is work and how it's performed. And last, we find out the two types of the efficiency for the hydraulic ram. Now first we understand the function of hydraulic ram. Now hydraulic ram is a one type of hydraulic device, okay, and it is used to transfer a water from a low head to high head without using electricity. That is a function of hydraulic ram. At the home, we use the pump for transferring the water from our ground floor to our water tank that is located on the terrace. So in which pump we are supplying the electricity, but in hydraulic ram we are not require any electricity. So for that we have a constraints of quantity of water. So here I have written the proper functions of a hydraulic ram. It is used for pumping a small quantity of water to higher level. That means supplying the small quantity of water at our terrace from available large quantity of water at the low level. Means water available at our ground floor, it is in larger quantity. The water available in a our ground floor in larger quantity is supplied to the our terrace, that means at the higher level or a high head, but its quantity is a small quantity. So that is a criteria of the quantity is there. So large quantity of water at the low head is transferred in a small quantity at to the higher head without using any electricity. This is the function of a hydraulic ram. Next, we study the constructions of a hydraulic ram. For that we require to the figure of hydraulic ram. So this is the figures of hydraulic ram, and it have a different component. So this is the supply tank from where the water is to be the supply. From the supply tank, water is going into the supply pipe, then it is passed into the supply valve, then after it is valve box. In the valve box there is a two valve. One valve is the waste valve V1 and another valve is the delivery valve V2. Then after this is the air vessel, then after next part is delivery pipe, and this is the delivery tank. So these are the different components of a hydraulic ram. Now in that you need to explain the two things, that is a waste valve V1 and delivery valve V2. This both the valve is a one way valve, that means it's flow only in one directionals. And this waste valve is open inside. That is it. That waste valve is open inside and it's closed in when it is move upward, it is a close. And this delivery valve is open outside, means it is open towards the air vessels. When the delivery valve come in downward direction, it's close the flow of waters. Okay. Now next we study the working. So hydraulic ram is working on a principle of water hammer effect. Hydraulic ram is working on a principle of water hammer effect. So you already know what is water hammer effect. Water hammer effect means when the water flowing, it's suddenly come into the raised positions, its pressure is increased. And due to this pressure, we supplying the small quantity of water to the high head. It is known as the principle of water hammer. So water is coming from this supply valve or a supply pipe with high velocities or a high velocity, then it's fill into the valve box. Means in a valve box water is come into the rest conditions. Okay, so water level is start to increasing in this valve box. So water level is increased up to certain levels, then suddenly the waste valve V1 is closed. When the valve box is completely filled the water, then the waste valve V1 is closed. When the waste valve V1 is closed in a valve box, pressure is rise suddenly. So pressure rising suddenly, then what happen? This delivery valve V2 is open. Okay, this delivery valve is connect the valve box and air vessel. So when the delivery valve is open, the water from the valve box with the high pressure is supplied into this air vessel. So in the air vessel, there is a air is already available. So in the air vessel, water level is start to increase. When the water level is increased, so air inside the air vessel is start to compressed, means its pressure is increased. So after some time, what happened? This air is applying the pressure on this water level. Okay, so this compressed air is start to applying the pressure on this water level. Then after, the water is start to flow in this delivery pipe, and through the delivery pipe, water is delivered in this delivery tank. So this way system is run continuous. Before finding out efficiency, I request to subscribe my channels for watching the more video. For hydraulic, different hydraulic devices, go to the playlist, and also the link is provided in the description. Now next we find out the different efficiencies. Before finding out this efficiency, we are required to learn the different parameters. So which parameters we learn? That is a W, that is a weight of the water flowing per second into the chamber, means that is a water supply. So this water supply in larger quantity, so we use the capital letters for that. In an outlet, weight of water coming in a lower quantity, so we use the small letter W. Okay, then after capital H. Capital H means the height of water rise from the chamber. From this chamber, water supplied in this delivery tank. So this height is known as the capital H. So it is a height is maximum. That's why it is indicated as the capital letter. Then next is the small h. That is the height of water level in a supply tank above the chambers. So it is a smaller head. So we use the small letters. So where the quantity is larger, then we use the capital letter. When it is quantity is smaller, then we use the smaller letters. Okay, now so there are only four parameters on the basis of we find out the efficiencies. So first we find out the deambiguation efficiency. So always the efficiency is equal to the energy delivered to the energy supply. That means it is the output upon input. Now what is the our output? So output is available in this delivery tank. In this delivery tank, the that is a head is capital H. That is a capital H means that is a height from the valve box to the water level in a tank into quantity of water. That is only two parameters, quantity or a weight. Instance of this weight, we are also able to use the Q quantity. Okay, so either here we write the small Q or a WQ, it is also right. Okay, so output power is capital H into small Q or a small W. Into what is our input power or supply power? That is a head is small h. Into water is available in larger quantity, so we use the capital W or either we use the capital Q. So this is the final equation for a deambiguation efficiency. For hydraulic ram, we are practically achieve the efficiency is the 10 to 20%, because we are transferring the water without electricity, so we are not able to achieving the more efficiency. So without supplying any energy, we are able to achieve the 10 to 20% efficiency for a hydraulic ram. Next, we find out the Rankine efficiency. Rankine efficiency is same, that is the energy delivered upon energy supply or output upon input. But in this Rankine efficiency, Rankine is tell that the water is already available at the small h head. Okay, that means we are only able to achieving the actual head, that is a capital H minus small h, means from this level to this level we are supplying the water. At this small h level, water is already available. So they are considering that the output head is not a capital H, it is a capital H minus small h. So they are also right that the water is already available at the small h. So actual head available, that is a capital H minus small h. And what is our actual input? For actual input, that is a small h is already there. And what is about the quantity of water? That are considering the quantity of water is capital W minus small w. So this equation is written like that, energy delivered so upon energy supply into small w, means quantity delivered in the delivery tank is small w, and head, that head is capital H minus small h, because the water is already available at the small h, so they minus it. Energy supply is at the small head and the quantity is the capital W minus small w. Instance of this W, we are also able to writing down the Q. If you have any query related to this theory, you can comment. If you learn something, then also comment on this video. And you want to watch another video, then you also comment to upload this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like my video, subscribe my channels, and share with your friend.